Next topic, exercise 8.1, question number 5-6. Question number 5, show that if the diagonals of a quadrilateral are equal and bisect each other at right angles, then it is a square. Here, one quadrilateral given. I have already drawn the quadrilateral ABCD. Here, in this quadrilateral, diagonals are equal, AC and BD equal, and AC equal to BD, already given that. Bisect each other at right angles. Bisection means OA equal to OC, OB equal to OD. Here, bisect each other. And at right angles, angle AOB equal to angle BOC equal to angle COD equal to angle AOD equal to 90 degree. We have to prove that ABCD is a square. What is a square means what? All sides are equal. One of the interior angle is 90 degree. For these two steps we have to prove. AB equal to BC equal to CD equal to AD and one of the interior angles is 90 degree. Okay. Consider triangle. Here AD and AB equal. Okay. Consider triangle AOB and AOD. AOB. OD equal to OB given. OA equal to OA common. This angle 90 degree. These two angles are 90 degree. Angle AOD equal to angle AOB equal to 90 degree. Therefore, triangle AOD congruent to triangle AOB by SAS. SAS congruence criterion. These two triangles are congruent. These two triangles are congruent means corresponding parts are equal. What is the corresponding parts? AB equal to AD. Okay. Similarly, we can prove that BC equal to CD. BC equal to CD. Next, CD equal to AD. From here, next, AD equal to AB equal to BC. AB equal to AD, BC equal to CD, CD equal to AD, next AB equal to BC. From these four equations, we can write it as AB equal to BC equal to CD equal to AD. Next, we want to prove that one of the interior angles is 90 degree. Before that, here we have to prove that ABCD is a parallelogram. How can you prove this? Here, these two triangles are equal, already proved this. These two triangles are congruent. Then you can write it AB equal to BC equal to CD equal to AD. Then next we have to prove that interior angles, one of the interior angles is 90 degree. Consider triangle AOD and triangle COB, OA equal to OC, OA equal to OC given. Next, OD equal to OB given. Next, angle AOD equal to angle COB. Vertically opposite angles are equal. opposite angles are equal, then we can write it SAS, these two triangles are congruent. Therefore, triangle AOD congruent to triangle BOC by SAS congruence criteria. Here, these two triangles are equal means corresponding parts are also equal. This angle also equal. That means what? Angle ADO equal to angle CBO. Corresponding parts of a congruent triangles. Okay. Here these two angles are equal means these two sides are parallel. Okay. This line acts as a transversal. Then AD parallel to BC. Same, we can prove that AB parallel to DC also. AB parallel to DC. Except here, that means what? ABCD is a parallelogram. In parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. And next year, opposite angles are also equal. And same thing, you can write it's AD and BC are parallel lines, AB and DC are parallel lines. Next year, we have to prove that angle, one of the angle should be 90 degrees. Next year, triangle, consider triangle B. Triangle ABC and triangle BAD. BAD. Consider triangle ABC and triangle BAD. AB equal to BA common. Next year. AD equal to BC, opposite sides of a parallelogram. Next year, AC equal to BD given. Three sides equal, definitely you can write it triangle ABC congruent to triangle BAD by SSS congruence criteria. Okay, that means here A, B, C, this angle, and B, A, D, this angle also equal. Okay, that means angle B equal to angle A, CP, CD, corresponding parts of a congruent triangles. Here, A, D and B, C are parallel, A, B act as a transversal. Then angle A plus angle B equal to 180 degree. Okay. Angle A plus angle B equal to 180 degree. Because what's the reason? AD parallel to BC. Okay. Angle A and angle B are co-interior angles. Angle B equal to angle A. Then you can write it 2 angle A equal to 180 degree. Angle A equal to 180 degree divided by 2 equal to 90 degree. Angle A equal to 90 degree. Angle B also 90 degree. ABCD is a parallelogram. Then opposite angles are equal. Angle A equal to angle C. Then 90 degree. Angle B equal to angle D also 90 degree. 90 degree. Therefore, AB equal to BC equal to CD. We already proved that AB equal to BC equal to CD equal to AD. Next, one of the angles equal to 90 degrees. That means ABCD is a square. Next, diagonal AC of a parallelogram ABCD bisects angle A. Show that it bisects angle C also. ABCD is a rhombus. Here given ABCD is a parallelogram. Angle bisects angle A. Bisects angle A means what? AC bisects angle A, that is angle 1 equal to angle 2. Next step to prove it bisects angle C also. That means AC bisects angle C also. Then next one, second one, ABCD is a rhombus. Proof. Here, ABCD is a parallelogram. Here AB and DC parallel sides, AC act as a transversal, angle 1 equal to angle 3. That means in alternate interior angle. Angle 1 equal to angle 3, alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles. It's the same way, angle 2 equal to angle 4. Angle 2 equal to angle 4, alternate interior angles. But already given that angle 1 equal to angle 2. Okay, this is the equation 1. Okay. This is equation 2, this is equation 3. From 1 and 3, angle 1 equal to 3, angle 1 equal to 2. That means angle 2 equal to 3. Angle 2 also 1, angle 3 also angle 1. Definitely you can write it angle 2 equal to angle 3. Okay, this is equation number 4. The next one, here from 2 and 4, what is it? 2, angle 2 equal to angle 4. What is the 4? Angle 2 equal to angle 3. Then from these two equations we can write it angle 3 equal to angle 4. That means these two angles are equal. That means what? AC bisects angle C also. That is, this implies AC bisects angle C. Next, we have to prove that ABCD is a rhombus. ABCD is a rhombus means what? All sides are equal. Here, from this equation 4, angle 2 equal to angle 3. Here, angle 2 equal to angle 3. In triangle ADC, angle 2 and angle 3 are equal. That means these two sides are equal. That means sides opposite to equal angles are equal. Okay, that means AD equal to DC. From this equation, that means equation 4, from 4, angle 2 equal to angle 3, you can write it what? AD equal to DC. Okay, question number 5. Next one, from 2 and 3, we can write it as what? Angle 1 equal to angle 4. From 2 and 3, we can write it as angle 1 equal to angle 4. This is equation number 6. Angle 1 equal to angle 4. Here consider triangle ABC. Angle 1 and angle 4 are equal means AB equal to BC. Side opposite to equal angles are equal. Then from this equation you can write it AB equal to BC. Same reason, side opposite to equal angles are equal. Equal. Here AD equal to DC, AB equal to BC. Here ABCD is a parallelogram. What is the properties of parallelogram? Here opposite sides are equal. AB equal to DC, opposite sides of a parallelogram. Question number 7. Next is same thing, AD equal to BC. Same reason. Question number 8. From 5, this is 7th equation, this is 8th equation, this is 9th one. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. From this equation, not 6, sorry. We can AD equal to DC, AB equal to BC, AB equal to DC, AD equal to BC. From these four equations, we can write it as AB equal to BC equal to BC equal to what? AD equal to AD equal to what? DC equal to DC. Four sides are equal, then ABCD is a square.